Hey, welcome back to Kevin Wilson SBC. I want to do a very quick video. I'm getting email after email and comments about pinion angles. Guys, let's simplify pinion angles, especially for a four link in a drag racing situation. Let's cover this one final time. Let's stop making this too difficult. I've got three examples on the chalkboard here. We're talking four link. The engine transmission angles are on the left. What I recommend as the static starting pinion angle is on the right for these examples. If your angles over here are different, then I'm going to walk you through how to apply these three examples to your car. When we set the pinion angle on the rear end, we have to know the engine and transmission angle. So if you can get somewhere on the engine, preferably a machine surface like the starter pad where the starter mounts, or if you have a balancer or a machine pulley that is pressed onto the crank, you can get off of that as well. But you need to know the angle of your engine and transmission and the direction of that angle before you set your pinion angle to go out and go drag racing. So here in the first example, let's say the engine is set to zero. The engine and transmission is at a 0 degree angle. So I'm going to set the pinion 1.5 to 2 degrees down on the rear end. And when I say down, let's assume the front of the car is here where the arrows are pointing. So we're looking at the driver's side of the car. So we're looking at the left side of the car. Engine is zero on a four link, especially with the strength of the four links produced today. I generally shoot for a 1.5 to 2 degree offset static so that under load on the hit, the pinion and engine transmission center line, we're trying to get them parallel to each other under load. I know at static ride height, they're not parallel. So driving around the pits, driving down the return lanes, you know, it's not going to be parallel. So when I say down, I mean that the pinion yoke is pointing down towards the track. So 0 degree and pointed down towards the track, 1.5 to 2 degrees. In all of my examples, I'm going to have about a 1.5 degree offset statically at ride height, car race ready, everything ready to go. All right, so let's say the engine and transmission is pointing down 2 degrees as we go from the front to the rear end. The engine and transmission is pointing down 2 degrees. Well, I'm going to have the pinion pointing up 0.5 degree, because as the pinion rotates and everything rotates under load, I'm shooting for a 1.5 degree offset. So 1.5 plus 0.5 is 2 degrees. So this is going down 2 degrees. This will be going up 2 degrees. My center lines are parallel. All right, let's say the engine and transmission is pointing up 2 degrees. So as we go to the rear of the car, the engine and transmission's pointing up, which is not uncommon, especially for big tire slick cars. If the engine and transmission is pointing up 2 degrees, I'm going to have the pinion pointing down 3.5 degrees at static ride height. So as the pinion gets hit and the rear end rotates up, I'm shooting for 1.5 degrees up. So up 2 degrees, under load, the pinion is going to come up to 2 degrees, and these two are going to be parallel. That's how you set your pinion angle. Now, I have a video that goes into this more detail, and I do not ignore drive shaft angles. Let's take an extreme example that I have actually gotten in emails from viewers. An engine and transmission sitting at a 5 degree angle down towards the rear of the car, and they know they need the pinion to be 5 degrees up under load so that the two center lines are parallel. But when I began to investigate the driveshaft angle,
in more than one example, I've had a 5-degree angle of the drive shaft coming up towards the pinion. So let's look at this. What's the working angle here? Because these are opposing angles, in other words, the angles are going in opposite directions, you have to add these two together. This is a 10-degree working angle. This is also, under load, if set properly, is going to be a 10-degree working angle. So they're parallel. However, what I'm telling you is that much of a working angle is not ideal. It's not ideal in drag racing. You are introducing extreme loads on the universal joints of your driveline angle, and this is not what I'm shooting for. You can set up your driveline angles however you want to. So you may say, well, Kevin, what the heck would you do to correct this? I would change the angle of the engine and transmission and get this more under control. I don't want a 5-degree engine transmission angle pointing down towards the rear of the car, nor do I want a 5-degree angle of it pointing up. I'm looking for a balanced combination for my driveline angles to keep non-uniform velocity under control. And at the end of the day, I'm trying to get the engine and transmission centerline, the driveshaft centerline, and the pinion centerline all in a straight line. And if you think about a radial car, as the chassis comes up and separates, it's pulling the back of the transmission angle up and it's driving the front angle down. Remember, take a look in the description and look at the video of that drag radial car and what's going on with the working angle of the drive shaft and the pinion. Take a look at that. The chassis dynamics that are at play on a big tire car or a radial car and how that impacts angles. Obviously, when the front end is coming up off the ground, of course, with driveline angles, guys, I have to assume that everyone understands that the engine and transmission should be centered between the frame rails. I don't think I should have to go into a lot of explanation on why that is. You don't want your engine and transmission angle doing this, and then your pinion angle kind of doing this. That's ridiculous, right? We're really shooting for a centered pinion and a centered engine transmission angle. So getting these centered in your chassis, I have to just kind of, you know, make sure you guys understand that's just a given. If these are not centered left or right in your chassis, then start there. Let's get that corrected. Let's get the drive line centered between the frame rails. And I like a centered pinion. I don't like an offset pinion left or right. I prefer a centered pinion. Some of my small tire slick cars, they may have about a 1-degree downhill angle. And a lot of my no prep cars are running a little bit of a 1-degree or 1.5 to 2-degree downhill angle because they're trying to get the crankshaft higher in the chassis. A small tire, especially a no prep car, I may bring the center line of the engine and transmission up in the chassis and even have about a 1-degree downhill angle as long as I have the drive shaft pointing to the yoke and not some crazy offset between the drive shaft distance and the yoke distance.
Go watch that video so you can understand working angles for the drive shaft at the transmission and the drive shaft at the pinion. Do not ignore your working angles, and that video covers why. So listen, this is a short video talking about pinion angles. This should be and will be my last video talking about drag racing pinion angles. There you have it. Just remember, we're trying to do three things. We want to go fast, we want to go straight, and we want to be safe. Thanks, guys.